is The Final Word.
And good evening. I'm Jenna Harner, and welcome to The Final Word, the show that invites you, the fans, into the conversation. You can get your opinion on TV right here every Sunday night. And let's get started by introducing you to tonight's three panelists. Please welcome afternoon host at 105.9 The X, Mark Madden.
Jenna, I have some terrible news. I'm told that Juju Smith-Schuster may start next season on IR because he injured his hands, elbows, and knees crawling back to Pittsburgh.
From our partner, DKFitzerSchwartz.com, Dan Kovacevic.
I have some worse news. At Mark Madden's request, we'll be talking Pirates at some point tonight.
And from the Trib, Steelers radio host Tim Benz.
I know we do have some viewers in West Virginia, and I just want them to notice that my tie is orange and blue, that's a total coincidence. Only one I could find.
Only one you can find tonight. Complete coincidence. Well, some of the topics we'll be talking about tonight. Five words on how Steelers free agency is going. What's the best way for the Penguins to address their second, third, and fourth line with the absence of Evgeny Malkin and Teddy Bluger? Is the best course of action in free agency or in the draft when it comes to a running back for the Steelers? And did the NCAA handle the VCU COVID situation the right way? But first, the night's big topic. Earlier this week, Juju Smith-Schuster signing a one-year, $8 million contract to stay in Pittsburgh. Is the Juju Smith-Schuster signing more beneficial for the Steelers or for Juju? Mark, I know you have a lot you want to say regarding this one.
Well, time will tell if it benefits the Steelers. I don't see the wisdom of retaining a slot receiver when five regulars are leaving from that great defensive unit they had. But it benefits Juju more by far because it was the best offer he got. I don't believe for one second he got a better offer and turned it down for his love of Pittsburgh. If he loved Pittsburgh so much, he could have worked out a deal to stay weeks, even months ago. I think all that was fabricated before the fact to get leverage against the Steelers and after the fact to save face. Free agency is about getting the best offer, and this was the only offer Juju got. He abjectly failed at free agency, and all his shenanigans, his social media, his look at me, attention junkie behavior, it hurt him, no doubt. Look at Golladay, the money he got for the New York Giants. Juju had better stats, more productive over the course of their parallel careers. Juju failed at free agency.
Dan, who does it benefit more, Juju or the Steelers?
Well, I don't care if it benefits Juju. I'm looking at this from the Steelers' standpoint. And, you know, to Mark's point earlier about losing some defensive guys, that to me is what really stings out of this. In my mind, when I look at the chronology of this, the Steelers prioritized keeping Juju. They were going to wait. They were going to wait to see what happened when he went out on the open market. And in the process, they were going to kind of sit and let other guys just leave. And I don't understand anything about their free agency to date, but especially that. You had a chance to keep together an elite defense. I don't think that's a stretch using that adjective there. That was an elite group for 2 years, and now you've lost four starters and another guy off of there, and you're rebuilding now even your secondary. It's just nonsensical.
Tim, your thoughts?
Sorry, Jenna, I got to make this a clean sweep. Of course it benefits Juju more because it was the best deal that he could find, to Mark's point. And then to follow up on what Dan said, I'll be just a little bit more specific. Dan was talking about the defense at large. I'll talk specifically about the cornerbacks, and I get it. It looks dollar for dollar, but it wasn't really dollar for dollar, Nelson for Juju. But there is some sort of cause and effect there, or else they would have done this in advance. Or why not put voidable deals on the back of a restructured deal for Nelson then, right? So I look at the cornerbacks specifically. They've had 2 years of really good cornerback play, better cornerback play than we've seen in a long time. And I know that we got a little spoiled by it last year, and it didn't look quite as good this year, so we started to hate on Hayden and Nelson a little bit. But you know what? Four good corners like they had, down to two now. And it's been a while since the Steelers have had cornerback depth. I hope you remembered what it looked like going all the way back to December, because you're not going to see it again for a while.
And the notion that Juju staying is like free cap money and didn't cause anybody else to leave, that's a bunch of nonsense. With a salary cap, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction.
Well, a reminder, you can keep the comments coming. You can find us on Twitter at WPXI Final Word, on Facebook at The Final Word. And now it's time for five words. Give us five words on how free agency is going for the Steelers. From Twitter, Vic Harrison 8 says, same old, unfortunately. Mike Clark with The Standard is the Standard. And on Facebook, Craig Hatch says, they really could do better. Mark, your five words, how's it going for the Steelers?
Well, this will come off as a bit repetitive after the discussion so far, but my five words are losing five regulars on defense. Was it really more important to keep your slot receiver than to keep even one more component from that great defense with the Steelers? Dupree was always going to leave. There was no avoiding that. But what if you could have kept Mike Hilton instead of Juju? Mm. Alualu instead of Juju? You should have.
Dan?
The draft couldn't be bigger. And you hate to go into a draft anytime, any sport, needing to address certain positions, and that's where the Steelers have left themselves. No doubt that they're going to have to look at X number of spots now that they have to fill instead of just getting the best player, and it didn't need to be that way. That's not all on Juju and the Juju signing, but that's part of it.
Tim, your five words.
Steelers free agency? Huh. Did it even start yet? I mean, I know they lost a bunch of guys, but who'd they go out and get? The next Tyler Matakevich, the next guy to be Zach Banner, now that Zach Banner is a starter. When you talk about Steelers free agency, meaning perhaps them going out and getting guys, they can't, and I don't know that they will. And Deion's exactly right. How many guys do you think they're going to be able to draft this year? They can redraft the whole team?
Well, don't go anywhere. We have a whole lot more to talk about from Pens hockey to March Madness. Still to come, what's the best way for the Penguins to address the second, third, and fourth line with the absence of Evgeny Malkin and Teddy Bluger? Jason Bassani on Twitter says it's a reminder to keep expectations in check, and in particular, how important being healthy will be for this team just to get into and have a fighting chance to advance in the playoffs. That's all it should mean. Stick with us. The conversation continues next.